With so many people, so many roads, and so much wildlife here in the Susquehanna Valley, nasty meetings are a fact of life. And at this time of year, many road encounters seem to be of the odoriferous kind. GAL's Jack Hubley has more on why in tonight's Wild Moment.
Hi everyone, this is Sammy, the official Wild Moment skunk. You'll notice he looks a lot better than the skunks you've been seeing lying on the road lately. So how come there's such a blip on the road-killed skunk graph this time of year? That's what Doug Forback wanted to know. He writes, recently my wife Donna and I traveled from Chambersburg to State College. My wife counted 14 dead skunks on the road by the time we got to State College. It seemed when the smell from one skunk left our SUV, we came upon another. What's going on here? Why are skunks so active this time of year? They certainly can't be looking for grubs on the road. Doug, you're absolutely right. Those skunks aren't looking for grubs on the road. They're looking for love, in this case, in all the wrong places. Skunks don't hibernate, but they do sleep throughout much of the winter in underground dens, living off stored fat. Then along comes February, and off goes the reproduction alarm. The skunk's breeding season lasts from about mid-February to early March, and individual females are in estrus, or breeding condition, for only about 4 to 5 days, so male skunks have no time to lose. They travel from den to den in search of eligible females. And here in the Susquehanna Valley, any cross-country hike soon brings you to a road. Stoked as he is with hormones, the last thing on Mr. Skunk's mind is looking both ways. Hence the dead skunk in the middle of the road, stinking to high heaven. As for Sammy here, he lives at the Hubley house. He was bred in captivity, and he's not allowed to date. On top of that, he's been neutered, so he doesn't know what he's missing, and he doesn't care. Some may consider him a pathetic vestige of his wild heritage. But Doug, I think you'll agree, it sure beats getting smashed. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
Now, if your dog has an encounter with a skunk, Jack says forget the tomato juice we all hear about. He has the three ingredients you need for a good anti-skunk wash. First of all, 1 quart of hydrogen peroxide, 1/4 cup of baking soda, 1 tablespoon of dishwashing liquid. Mix well and slather all over your smelly dog, then rinse and repeat if necessary. Jack says your canine should smell much better. And if you missed that recipe, we've got Jack's formula posted on the News 8 at 5:30 Facebook page.